everybody. This is the first video to the segment from Earth and Sky called Tea with D.
And A.
Yay! I was so excited. So we have been discussing doing something like this for actually quite a long time. And the way the universe works, it never lined up. So finally, during this Mercury retrograde, which is done next week, mm-hmm. we took the plunge and are getting this started. So what this segment is mostly about, what we're trying to accomplish here, is to give all you viewers an intimate look on our lives and basically our friendship and how we apply what Earth and Sky Center teaches to our own everyday lives. We'll add up new information on subjects and new information about ourselves and things that are going on. We decided to do it on the format of tea, because when people have tea, as most of you Europeans know, that's the social time. That's when you talk about politics and religion and things that affect you in your everyday life, or just BS, however it goes. So that's kind of what we've decided that we were going to do. And I'll let Angela.
Exactly. So it's just a really nice, like a little peek into our world. We have a lot of conversations with each other, and we thought it might help to give that little glimpse to all of you. We'll talk about a wide range of topics depending on what's going on in our lives, what the forefront topic is, what we've been utilizing. Several different things we'll probably be covering, anything from sacred geometry, which Deanna is amazing at. She has done so much research and study and application of it. She's actually the one that taught me how to start using sacred geometry, and I use it every day now. So I can't imagine my life without it, and it's done many, many just amazing things. We'll just swing right into it a little bit. I just got news yesterday from a friend I had done a sacred geometry grid for, along with a bunch of healing work, only using the grid primarily, a little bit on him, but primarily through the grid, and he just found out his MS is gone.
Yay!
Yes!
Yay! See, it's just powerful. One aspect. One aspect is using it for healing, remote healing. And anybody who is a Reiki practitioner, regardless of what line you use, we use grid work, and mm-hmm. the grids, it connects the whole planet. There's actually, I don't know if you know this, did I teach you this when we were doing the master class about the grid that's at the North Pole, the Reiki grid?
Yes,
yeah,
I
so there's that. There's the Reiki grid, and anybody who's taken Reiki 2 or 3, or some 4, it depends on who your teacher is. Sometimes the classes get split up into 2 classes per level. There's a Reiki grid that is at the North Pole that all of us Reiki practitioners / master teachers, we create a grid in the home, and that sends the energy to that grid in the North Pole, and it's to heal the world.
Yeah, exactly. And there's one day a month where all the practitioners come together, anyone who joins in, and you can, everybody at that same time joins in and sends the power to it, which is phenomenal. Yeah. But it can happen at any point, of course.
Absolutely.
The grid is always there. So
absolutely.
Some of the other fun things that we'll probably be talking about, too, will be talking about animal totems. And
yeah, and you're really good at that, as animal whisperer over here.
So we've had some fun experiences recently with foxes and eagles that once we get to that segment, I can't wait to share with you downtown Flint foxes and eagles and how that came to be.
Yeah, there's a lot of bald eagles that have actually came that are in the last few years to the Flint, Genesee County area.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
I saw my first one last year. I was kayaking the Flint River. I know, I'm brave. It's okay. And I saw my first bald eagle, and bald eagles, I don't know if you guys are aware, but eagles fly the highest of any of the birds in the animal kingdom. Mm-hmm. And this eagle was like right by the water, so he must have been hunting.
Oh, beautiful.
But it's right by the water, and I'm like, oh, yes. I get the message, universe, yay!
Yes, yes, exactly. Just so exciting.
Absolutely, yep.
Yeah, and then
so we'll probably touch on herbs and stuff like that since we are drinking tea. This is the New Orleans Rubius Red Tea, which is our Bourbon Street Red Tea, which is from Saugatuck, Michigan, which if you've never been,
wonderful,
oh my gosh,
place.
I love that place.
Yeah.
There's actually three ley lines that go cross right underneath Saugatuck and that neighboring town. I think it's like
South Haven.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they all kind of cross there. So the energy, like the artistic, creative energy in that whole area is just absolutely amazing.
Yeah. And if you go to Saugatuck, I highly recommend the Seymour House Bed and Breakfast. Patty is the name of the hostess at the house. She is wonderful. She'll give you a multi-course gourmet breakfast that's made with things that are fresh on the property. They have berries that you can pick in the back, and she uses the berries to make jam. She has a chicken house, and those are the fresh eggs in the morning. It's amazing. It's a beautiful little Italian briquette house with about, I think there's about 5 rooms, or you can rent the cabin in the back. If you want a more rustic feel instead of the Italian-style house, you can rent the cabin. It has 2 bedrooms and walking trails through the woods in the back. I've seen deer back there.
I didn't even know that.
It's wonderful.
I need to do more B&Bs. I've only done one B&B in my life, and it was, I can't remember. It was on that side of the state. I can't remember the name of it or anything, but it was a really great experience. We had like this huge table and breakfast with everybody.
And it's fun to socialize with people you don't know and find out where they're traveling from.
Absolutely. Make connections. Yeah. As humans, we are all looking for connections. And
once we started the B&B route, we're just hooked on it now.
I think I'm going to jump on that bandwagon.
We'll have to go out there together sometime. We had some other friends go out there recently. A couple of our friends that got married, we've sent them, both couples on their honeymoons there. And so we want to do a friends trip and just rent out the house.
We
should do
that.
We'll do a video while we're there,
Heck yeah. We'll do some remote stuff, maybe some live Facebook stuff, which please check out both of our Facebook pages. You can either see my personal page, Deanna Zayats, or you can go to Mind Body Spirit Healing by Deanna Zayats and check out some information that I post there. I post a lot of the health and wellness information that I have there. And then I have Monday 10-minute meditations with the gongs, which we'll talk about that too. We're going to talk about singles, tuning forks, different types of sound therapies. We have a lot of stakes in the fire.
We really do. So a little bit about us too, for those who don't really know, in Earth and Sky too, definitely check out our Earth and Sky page if you haven't already liked that. Please like our Facebook page and subscribe to us on YouTube. You can actually choose on YouTube if you want to get all of our notifications. If you do that, you'll get notifications before we tell everybody else about them. And you can also set it so you just get a few of the notifications on YouTube. But that's the channel we're hoping to expand the most. So if you'd subscribe to our YouTube channel, that will really help us with the cause that we are trying to further to the world. We do Sunday Life Talks. We actually record those on Wednesday evenings for anybody who wants to join us in person. We do a singing bowl meditation Wednesday evenings as well for those who join us in person. But we're not broadcasting more of the meditations currently, but there are several of those out there on the channel for people. And a little bio, though, just to know about who we are for those who don't know us already. I'm Angela Roth, or on Facebook, Angela L. Alexander Roth.
She has had the huge title. With the lipstick.
Yes, and I never leave the house without lipstick. So I am a metaphysician. I'm currently studying also to get my doctorate in metaphysics. I love metaphysics because it describes the science behind the mystical. There are so many things in life that we originally thought were magical, and then when there's something that's unknown, so many people fear the unknown. And I like the fact that when you study metaphysics, it uncovers the meaning behind it, the reason, the how-to of it. And so it takes away that fear for people that are a little apprehensive of it because it can explain it. So I'm studying my doctorate in that currently. I'm very excited. It's a lot of work, but well worth it.
I'm behind you. I'm actually going to be enrolling in the same college that she goes to online because I'm good like that.
Fantastic.
And I probably will work towards the doctorate as well in metaphysics because for the same, her and I, this is part of reason why we're, because we both enjoy the science aspect behind everything.
Yes.
We both like to kind of tear it apart and look at everything from each little angle to see how it works, how the energies work. And energy is such a mystery to us still after we've known about electricity for how many years now, and we still don't really fully understand where electricity comes from. We just know how to collect it and generate it and expand it. And it, you know, it can't be destroyed.
And it's the same thing with energy healing. Yeah. That's how it is with electricity. Well, energy healing, we're both master healers. Uh-huh. And with energy healing, you're taking that energy, you're gathering it from the universe, you're collecting it, you're sending it, you're utilizing it. It's the same property. How's it all work? Well, we'll talk about that with the metaphysics and the science behind it.
Absolutely. So how about you let them know about your little fur babies and what else you do in your spare time.
Okay, yes, Madam. We should do the rest of the introduction here too. So this is Daddy Kitty. He's our official greeter here at our house. And he has a fantastic fur motor. I don't know if you can hear it on camera. Sometimes he shows up on camera with that purr, sometimes not. Spunky is right here next to the beautiful Deanna Zayats. And she is a very spunky girl. Actually, I'm surprised nobody's flanking me on the right. We have a little bit of a black and white theme in our house, too. Right. Not on purpose, but that's kind of how it happened. And
just trying to show that all colors live in harmony.
Right, exactly. And here comes Little Karma, actually. But Alley Cat Angels is my foundation. And so it's a way for me to help various nonprofits. I specialize in large-scale fundraising and media for various nonprofits, and my biggest passion lies with the stray cats. So I do teach cat certification classes, so if you take the certification class, then any cat, if you're in the Michigan area, especially mid-Michigan, will be easiest for you. Then any stray cats that you want to get spayed and neutered, we can do it for just $25. That includes the anesthesia injection that lasts 3 days for the pain control, and we also give them a rabies vaccine with that as well. So there's no excuse for cats to still be free roaming and not be fixed. If anybody comes around our house on four legs for more than a couple weeks, they get spayed and neutered. So
how come it's so important to get stray cats spayed and neutered and all that? What's the biggest significance for that?
Well, it's the population control. There's been many other methods that have been tried and failed. People have tried just trapping them and moving them to a different area, or killing them, and, you know, euthanasia, and all of the different things that they've tried have led to what's called the vacuum effect. The vacuum effect is because there is a certain number of cats that are outside, and they will stabilize in that area. If they recognize that there's an area without stray cats, then more will come in and fill that void. So if you pull cats out by any other method, more will come in and fill the void through the vacuum effect. And we don't want to have a plethora of kittens being born, and because when you have an uncontrolled number that continues to grow and be born, then that colony will get to be so large that it will end up attracting disease, and the colony will topple over, and then it will start again with just a couple cats, and we see this pyramid build and rise and then topple down. And so that's not fair to the cats either. We as people are guardians of the animals.
Right.
Animals on this planet are the innocent creatures. And so an easy thing, cats tend to be territorial. So if the cats are related to each other, if you have a colony that is not fixed, then they're going to be related to each other. They're going to let each other stay in that colony and just get bigger. But if you get the cats fixed, they're territorial, so they're going to prevent other cats from coming into the space. They're going to be great for catching, knocking things off of tables. And also, they're also going to be great at, you know, catching rodents, keeping the mice population
moles
down.
Y'all hate moles in your yard.
Cats are wonderful for that. But they do need you to be their guardian and get them spayed and neutered so that the numbers will be manageable. And that's the best way to do it. We have seen a huge result from this. Back in the early 90s, which is when I started, there were 12 million cats euthanized in shelters every single year. Just in the United States, 12 million, because there was such an overpopulation. Through these targeted spay-neuter efforts that have really been growing, they kind of started a little in the 70s, but they really took hold in the early 90s. And now it's 4 million a year annual. I actually heard that this next year it might be closer to 3 million. It was under 4 million. Now it's close to 3 million. So just in that short time, I've been doing it about 25 years, I think.
Uh-huh.
It's dropped less than 25%
right.
of the euthanasia that was happening. Wow. And that's because of the targeted spay neuter.
Yeah, so you don't have to kill something just to, you know, to control the population and all that. I mean, there's other methods that you could do. And that's really inspiring. I mean,
yeah. And you can see that goal finally happening now. And not all cats want to be an inside cat. Sometimes you get these feral cats that have been born generation after generation outside, and they're wild animals. You wouldn't bring a raccoon into your house or, you know, other wild animals. And cats have only been domesticated about half as long as the time of dogs. And that's they speculate if that's part of that independence that they...
Like 6,000 years, 5,000 years?
I don't remember.
Because I know dogs is about 10,000 last I heard. 10,000 years dogs and humans have had a relationship.
Yeah, I think it was in Persia that they started domesticating cats, but it's important to respect their spirit. So our rule is if you're inside our house, you're an inside kitty, you do not go in and out, because then that can draw in disease. You know, you can end up bringing a disease into your whole house. And there are a lot of dangers outside too, with cars and things like that. But for the cats that prefer to live their life outside, just give them a little bit of shelter, some food and water. But the number one thing is to please get them fixed. They're going to roam a lot less than two. Cats, male cats will roam up to 10 miles and females up to 5 miles. But once they're fixed, a male typically won't roam more than a mile at the very most, and a female cat will stay usually within about her block radius, so a couple blocks radius. So that prevents them from going over all those extra busy streets, too.
Right.
So many different effects with all of that.
Well, I have a cat named Athena, and she found me. Actually, Angela was there that day. I called her.
Mm-hmm.
And a friend of ours was closing down her shop, and Athena came up, this white cat, skinny, frostbite all over, and... just meowing, and so I was like, oh, I gotta get her food, so I fed her. Long story short, she became my cat. But she was obviously, somebody owned her at some point. She really loved people. Her spirit is indoor-outdoor cat. Mm-hmm. So she, during the summer, always wants to be outside. And then in the wintertime, she wants nothing to do with outside. So I got her all the proper vaccinations for the purpose of
That's
her
important.
Being outside.
Right.
So if you do have a cat and you're respecting their spirit,
right.
and you want that, and they want to be an indoor-outdoor cat, then you have to get them the proper vaccinations.
Absolutely.
That's
the protection that you can give to them. Yes.
Absolutely. Yeah. So she's like the Jill of all trades. She pretty much does all this volunteer work. She's always there out in the community helping everybody out, helping all the animals out. And everything else. And I just wanted to kind of point that out, because it's reflective on the kind of spirit that Angela is. And I don't think that we lift each other up enough as humankind, kind humans. So therefore, we were just talking about this before we decided to start. She had called me out on some stuff. And because we tend to undermine our talents.
We do, yes.
And we do that because we are drilled, you have to be humble. You can't stand out, because if you do, that's your ego, which we're going to talk about a healthy ego and an unhealthy ego. I know that a lot of my fellow metaphysical fighters for freedom tend to say, delete the ego, abolish the ego, overcome the ego, and that is not correct.
Right.
So we're going to get into that, but part of that is holding each other up. So this woman is amazing, and I wanted her to tell you about some of the things that she does, so that way her spirit can shine through and you can see who she really is, who the person behind Earth and Sky Center truly is, and that she's coming from a place of love and true spirit for humanity. She is a holy love generator who just wants to do her part to make this world a better place, and I think that is super important, especially you as the viewers, to know and to understand. So when you come to our channels, especially the Earth and Sky Center channels, and you see the teachings every Sunday, you know she's not doing this to get her 15 minutes of fame. She's not doing this to get rich. She's not doing this to have a lot of people give her the attaboys or anything. She's doing it because she truly just loves life and loves people and wants you to learn how to do the same thing.
Mm-hmm. That's true. And thank you. You're so sweet. And you're the same way. I know we both have this thing where we want to help heal the world and just show each other love. And you work so much with a lot of people with addictions, too, which is wonderful healing work. And Deanne actually volunteers her time a lot with the gong work, too, the healing of the gongs and working with people with addiction.
Absolutely. So I'm Deanna Zayats. You'll find me on Facebook under Deanna Zayats, because I don't have a beautiful long title.
I guess it could
be Deanna Christie Zayats. But every time I heard that as a kid, I was like, what? What do I do now? So if you can't tell already, I have a little more flair of a personality. Where it's on my head, on the tip of my head. Oh, lost for words. Anyway, I was gonna bring a tarot card reference in, but I totally muffed that one up. So yeah, I come from a family of addicts, and I have my own addictive personalities. Now, if you were to take a peek into my life and my addictions, you would be like, oh, that girl's never had a problem with addiction. Yes, I have, because especially when you're a seasoned addict, it's really easy to hide it. It's easy to hide it from people, and it's easy to hide it from yourself because you begin to believe your own lies. So I woke up one day, and I was about 24, and I said, I am going to actually become the woman that I'm pretending to be out in public. Nice. And when I started on that journey, and I'm 38 years old now, if you looked at me then and now, you wouldn't believe that they were the same person. And I understand what suffering is, and I truly don't want anybody to suffer. And if I can save people, let me rephrase that. If I can assist people in saving themselves so they don't have to suffer, then I'm going to do whatever it is in my power to do so. So I started learning about metaphysics. I was introduced to it through Wicca, because I was always... I always asked questions in church, and they didn't like that. So I started going to alternate religions, and Wicca was the easiest one because, of course, it was the 90s and the craft was out and everybody wanted to be magical. So I started with Wicca, and I feel I have grown past that and evolved past that. And so I don't really claim any specific religion. I'm kind of an omnist. I like all of them, and I think they all have truth in them, and through that you can reach other people and relate to them on a personal level, especially through religion and spirituality. So I do bring in, if I'm working with an addict who is Christian, I can talk Bible all day. Buddhism, the main religions I have a pretty good grasp on. I've been studying for 13 years. I started learning the healing arts to assist in working with people who are addicts, people with terminal disease, depression, and healing through that aspect. And now I'm going into the sound therapies with the gongs and the bowls and the tuning forks and all that. And now through my voice, through speech, because I enjoy talking so much, my goal is to eventually do seminars to assist people in reprogramming their brain through not just metaphysics, but through all aspects of life, because there's, four or five different aspects to a person? We'll get into that later. Mm-hmm. And so working through that is my gift to humanity, and how I feel that I am a holy love generator. I respect life. I don't condemn people for their choices. I just try to assist them in gaining a different perspective, a healthier perspective, so they can make better choices for themselves and truly know who they are.
Right.
Because that's the biggest question. Who am I?
Right, exactly. So we hope to use these segments, Tea with DNA, to get more in depth into all of this, to give you that little glimpse of how we use this in our lives. And if you are somebody who ever has an event coming up that you would like us to speak at, we are certainly open to that. We are looking to start traveling and teaching as well, and speaking on a wide variety of topics. So certainly let us know if you're interested in that, and please feel free to post down below if you have topics that you are looking to hear about, or if you have questions in your own life. And, you know, we as women especially, we have so many things that we deal with. Men do too, but so many things that we deal with in our lives all the time. And so it's nice to have supportive women around you and to be able to have somebody to talk to about these things. So we hope that our talks can bring a little bit of light to you and your lives. And we look forward to all of the future segments that we have coming up.
Absolutely. So, it'll be awesome. I'm super excited about it.
Yeah. Let us know your comments down below and your thoughts. If you have any questions, anything like that, please feel free to post those. We're open and excited to start sharing this with you.
Absolutely. And email us, or I'm sure the information's somewhere.
Down below.
Down below. Or there, or there, or wherever we post it, whenever we put this on YouTube. Yeah, feel free. There's no question that's stupid. And I will say, though, that those of you who enjoy trolling, we have no attachment to your antics, so we're not afraid to delete your little stuff. So just let's just be respectful of each other.
Keep it classy.
And keep it classy. I mean, I don't care if you disagree with what we say and you want to have a dialogue about it, but let's not get nasty about things. Because I've noticed on other stations such as this that, you know, some people, they can get really nasty about things that they don't, you know, so no negativity. We're not all about negativity here, so that's pretty much it. So hope you've enjoyed this cute little introduction. We will be posting weekly.
Weekly? Yep. Tuesdays okay. Will be Tea with DNA. And so with Earth and Sky too, if you like both of our pages, please. Mm-hmm. And then at Earth and Sky now, we have Life Talks on Sunday, Monday Moment of Reflection, Tuesdays Tea with DNA, and the Wednesday What segment. So, what?
I will be joining her for some of those whenever I don't have to work. And on my YouTube station, I will be, basically it's life reflective. So I will be inspired by spirit to talk to you about something, and it's not scripted. So feel free to come check out my channel and see what I have in store for you. It will always be a surprise. So until next time, love and light. Mwah. Bless. We love you. Have a great day.